We know that cells are really sensitive to a lot of different types of cues, chemical cues, as well as mechanical cues. And what we're trying to understand is how cells maintain a stable environment and how organisms maintain a stable environment in the face of all of this external stimulation. Now, the concept of homeostasis, or maintaining a stable internal environment, is one that physiologists have been aware of and have been working on for many, many decades. And basically, there's in this concept of homeostasis, a model cassette for how a stimulus can impact with a sensor and an effector pathway, and then via a combination of positive and negative feedback, control the environment and maintain stability. So how would this work when we're talking about exposure of cells and organisms to significant mechanical stress? Well, we know that there are many mechanosensitive organs in our body, bone, muscle, lung, the vasculature, the heart. And if cells and organs don't respond appropriately to mechanical signals, this can lead to very serious consequences and serious disease. In the case of bone, for example, which is a weight-bearing organ, if there's not sufficient weight on the bones, this can give rise to disuse osteoporosis. In muscle, as illustrated schematically here, there is a very, very dramatic response to mechanical stimulation, where if muscle is exposed to additional force or weight bearing, this can give rise to significant hypertrophy or expansion of the muscle mass. And in contrast, if muscle is not utilized due to disease or disuse, it can atrophy. And one of the ways in which this both hypertrophy and atrophy happens is by expansion of individual cells, the expansion of individual cells or the reduction in size of individual cells. So how is it that muscle cells can respond to these mechanical signals, communicate to the nucleus to either activate programs of gene expression that lead to more muscle growth or allow for decrease in muscle mass when it's not required? Similar response to mechanical stress is evident in the cardiovascular system. Chronic high blood pressure is known to put an additional load on the heart. And when that kind of condition exists, you can see that you get this morphological increase or hypertrophy of the heart. And we now understand that this is not due to the production of additional cardiac cells. We're born with the number of cardiac muscle cells that we're going to have when we die. However, excessive mechanical load or enhanced mechanical load causes the activation of cellular programs that lead to expansion of the size of individual cardiac muscle cells, and this ultimately leads to the expansion of the size of the heart. So here you can see unstimulated or unstressed cardiomyocytes, and here you can see corresponding cardiomyocytes from a heart that has been put under stress. And essentially what's happened here is those muscle cells are able to sense that increased mechanical load, and that signals them to activate and reactivate the fetal program for gene expression so that they build more contractile machinery. This, of course, is initially adaptive and provides for a mechanism by which the cardiac output can be enhanced to compensate for the increased load on the heart. But at some point, it becomes maladaptive and leads to cardiomyopathy. So where is this cell's stress sensor, and how are these mechanical signals sensed, and how are they responded to? One of the really interesting ideas, if you think about a cell and it's attached to the extracellular environment, and we have, as we've discussed before, these focal adhesions, which are specialized regions of the cell membrane that tether the cell to the extracellular environment. You can imagine that if this cell was being stretched, if you were pulling on this matrix here, that these focal adhesions would really serve appropriately as conduits for transmission of that force or the signals that result from that mechanical stimulation. And so we were really interested in exploring this possibility, first testing what is the normal cellular response to mechanical stretch, one, and where does this stress sensor reside, and three, what are some of the mechanisms by which cells compensate and respond to these mechanical cues.